Carter. Maybe we just discovered one of the components of space age music. Jazz was certainly an important component. Oh, hey, vinyl community, and welcome YouTubers from everywhere. No teaser here, folks. We're going to start out with the best. Out there with Betty Carter on the Peacock Progressive Jazz label. A very small label that didn't do very much. This was Betty Carter's first solo project. There's the record. I'm going to let the first two tracks on this album play because I think it's important. One of the best jazz records that nobody knows about has Kenny Dorham, Benny Golson, Tommy Grice, and Wynton Kelly on piano. And it has others. The first two tracks will show the diversity. This record from 1958. This is a 1988 reissue, and the reissues aren't easy to find either. Have the originals, no copies for sale in the U.S. on Discogs as of this video. 129 people have this record. 252 people want it. Yeah. Look, Betty peeking out of that Sputnik. How did she get in there? Sputnik was just about the size of a beach ball. But we don't have to worry about Betty, because NASA got a rocket down there waiting for her in case she gets into any trouble.
Oh, you're driving me crazy. What did I do? What did I do? My tears for you make everything hazy, clouding the sky of blue. How true would a person would hear me touching me, beating me, lady. But you were the kind who would hurt me, tell me when I need you. Oh, you're driving me crazy. What did I do to you? Well, no, you're not that light, I am not that light. I don't know how. choose to be. I'll not change you. I need you. Can you see? So try me, and maybe you'll love me, 'cause I can't help it. That's the
Carter had a long career, and I say watch this till the end, folks, because Betty's going to close us out. Want it all? You want it all in one record? Richard Heyman Voodoo, High Fidelity on Mercury. What is this? Is this a spaceman, or is this an alien with pom-poms doing voodoo music and dancing on the moon dust? No, you can have it all. One of the things, he doesn't have a wiki page, and he was around in the music business forever. So how do we find out about some of this stuff and get the information? Well, here's a little printout about Richard Heyman. I got this from spaceagepop.com. That's a great resource. And that was website was done in the 90s, and it was updated for some time. It's got some missing links and stuff on it, but it has tons of information. And that's a great place to go. So how do we find out about some of these records? How do we discover the records? How do we know what category they're in? Well, that's a site that will help you. Another site is Dr. Hoffman's Electric Kool-Aid Party on YouTube. I'll leave some links down below for these things, but you can listen to all of them, almost all of this music, on Dr. Hoffman's YouTube site and see pictures of the cover. And that's one of the ways we discover this kind of stuff. So how about a little conjuration? Richard Heyman, yeah, we need to know more about him. See, the cat wants to know more about him. He did a ton of stuff, okay? He did a really important record later on with Enoch Light on Project 3, and in his command days, he was involved in the much-coveted early Moog album, The Genuine Electric Latin Love Machine. I don't have that record. I bet that record's a hard one to find. Gives us something to look forward to. He went on in the music business for a long time. So later, he was a big part of the arrangement staff of the Boston Pops. Sometimes if Arthur Fiedler wasn't available, he conducted the orchestra. So what about Richard Heyman? We never probably heard his name before. Said a major component of this space age music was jazz. Well, Duke Ellington must be in there somewhere. The Cosmic Scene, Spaceman, Six Eye Columbia from 1958. Yeah. just keep coming. Ferrani and Teicher, only the best. What the heck? No, these is middle-aged Ferrani and Teicher when they went for the music business. But when they were young, they did a few records like this. Soundproof. The sound of tomorrow today. Really interesting stuff. Was turned on to these guys or these early records by our vinyl community friend Tuco. And they did doctored pianos and tried to get all kinds of strange sounds. And this is not the Ferrani and Teicher you know. Space Age, Space Suite, Bobby Christian and his orchestra on Audio Fidelity. Yeah, you want to learn a little bit more about him, spaceagepop.com. Check it out. From this album, a little bit of Blue Star. Audio Fidelity, we'll talk just a little bit about that. It's kind of important in this category of music. Audio Fidelity was originated in 1954. It is said that in 1957, they discovered how to record stereo music. They were a popular record during the time, and they did a lot of stuff with sound effects. They recorded locomotives. They did various things. I have other Audio Fidelity records, but I'm just going to show you a couple here to that you see how this works. Mallet Mischief, Harry Brewer and his quintet. Well, this looks like Bachelor Pad, doesn't it? But Discogs says it's Space Age Pop. So that's where we put it. Here's another Audio Fidelity record, doctored for Super Stereo. These are quite interesting records. And again, Discogs says this is Space Age Pop. We look at this cover, otherwise we wouldn't know what it is. No info about this group anywhere. Thank you. last record had a nice insert about audio fidelity and stereo disc catalog and technical data. A lot of fun there, folks. I'd like to have them all. Back there in that other room, I see you dude standing back there. You're thinking, yeah, this old geezer from the 50s, he probably never even heard of Sun Ra. Yes, I have. I got some Sun Ra. Recent craft reissue, audiophile record, great. The futuristic sounds of Sun Ra. Where is tomorrow? You didn't see coming. Zither magic. Ruth, welcome. Yeah. Discog says this is necessary space age in your collection. From 1959, and now what you've all been waiting for, Esquivel, Strings of Flame, exploring new sounds in stereo. Here's another record, just to show here, of Esquivel, about 1960. This was recorded on dual 35mm tape, kind of like the stuff that several other people were doing around this time. One of the things that's interesting to me, this is on the Reprise label. It's interesting that this kind of recording, this technology, was being used on the Reprise label. Yeah, everybody's familiar with that label and all the popular guys that were on it. Sinatra and all that kind of stuff, but nobody knows about this. And here is the record you've been waiting for. Latinesque, Esquivel. See what it says right down here? The sound your eyes can follow. There's the back. I'm going to read a little bit here. Stereo action is a new concept of music in motion, a new dimension in recorded sound. Stereo action brings you unmatched fidelity through the full sound spectrum, plus the exciting new illusion of sound in motion. Soloists and entire sections of the orchestra appear to move thrillingly back and forth across the room. Stereo action is musical movement, so real, your eyes will follow the sound. It says, if you've got a stereo set, you've got to have this Latinesque by Esquivel and his orchestra. I'd say this is true. This is one of the most interesting, fascinating finds I have had in a long time. And this is the one you want. This one has a die-cut cover. This is the heaviest cardboard sleeve I've ever seen on a single record. Ever. Amazing. So we got the die-cut cover. Here is the inner sleeve. So that's what you see through there. On the back of the inner sleeve is a description of each tune, what they were trying to accomplish, some of the tricks that they used, and so forth. I will read just a little bit here. This album represents, to the best of our knowledge, the first time in the history of stereo recording in which absolute separation of channels has been achieved. To accomplish this, the orchestra was separated into two parts of the studio, half in Studio One, the other half in Studio Two, almost a city block down the long corridor of the RCA building in Hollywood. There is no other record like this. There's the record. Really clean, nice condition. I don't care what kind of music you like. If you're a hi-fi guy, an audiophile, a stereo guy, and you want something unusual, this record is at the top of the list. 1962. If you're a record collector, you need this record. Video the other day, I made the comment that one of the things that all of these styles have in common is often they did the same tune. One of these was Autumn Leaves. Betty Carter and her trio, Munich, 1992. Don't fear, folks. The space age is gonna go on forever.
La 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 la
keep it going, guys. And I say, see you all down the trail.
Happy trails to you until we meet again.